Dearly beloved in Christ, I welcome you to this Saturday of the fourth week of Lent. I hope that we are not all burdened already by the stay-at-home policy of the government. It is for your good. It is for my good. But then we thank the Almighty God for the gift of life. For those of you at home watching me, listening to me, if you have the prayer for an end to the coronavirus pandemic, please bring it out, because at the end of this, we shall be praying together. But for the reflections for today, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, yes, indeed, we are pained by the situations of the time, but also we are encouraged by the fact that where there is life, there is hope. And since God is the author of life, we trust ourselves to Him, and we know that we can never be overshadowed by any coronavirus. But in the gospel passage of today, beloved in Christ, witness the disturbing thing that happened even amongst the Pharisees. Already the confusion in their camp. To some of them, oh, let us kill Jesus. He is a fake Messiah. But to some of them, oh, he speaks like one who is truly sent by God. Sometimes, even in the kingdom of the demons, the light comes and scatters our shadows, and shatters the darkness in the kingdom of the demons. And so, beloved in Christ, we are empowered and encouraged today, even in the midst of our own pains, to know that the light of Christ will overshadow this our darkness. And that is what happened even in the camp of the Pharisees. On this Saturday, their plot was still to do away with the Messiah. But guess what? For fear of the people, for fear of some other contingencies, but most importantly, for fear of the power in the word that is so proclaimed, that some of them had to say, no one has ever spoken like this. Beloved in Christ, do you still have confidence in the word of God? Do you still have trust in the word of God? If Jesus says yes, nobody can say no. No matter how many they are that sit together to seek counsel against us, the Lord will always put confusion in their camp. Coronavirus is not strong enough to bring me and you down. And so we are not scared, we are not afraid, we are not cowed in. Indeed, we entrust ourselves to the power in the word. And that power in the word is the only salvation that humanity has. Beloved in Christ, let us continue to entrust ourselves to the care of God during this Lenten season, a time for fasting, a time for praying, a time for almsgiving, a time for thinking of others, a time for thinking of God, a time for thinking of doing something for the living God. But against this coronavirus, join me in praying for an end to this epidemic. O God, our help in ages past, we your children humbly implore mercy at this time of adversity. We are devastated by the coronavirus pandemic that is ravaging the whole world, snuffing life out of your people and spreading fear everywhere. You are the God of life and nothing is impossible to you. You ask us to call on you in the day of trouble and you will answer us. We know that we are sinners who are worthy of your favors. Although we have no merits of our own to plead before you, we stand on the merits of the death and resurrection of Christ and plead his saving blood over our lives and situation. We ask you to be merciful to us and save us from this scourge that is devastating the world. Be gracious to us and speak life and healing into the present coronavirus scourge and command it to depart from our world. Give leaders of governments and scientists divine wisdom and knowledge to take the right decisions and to develop the vaccine needed to stem the spread of this virus. Protect all health workers and volunteers. Look with pity on those who are already infected with this deadly virus and heal them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died from it and comfort those they left behind to mourn their demise. Lord, through this scourge, May the hearts of many be turned back to you, their Creator. We ask this our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may God bring an end to coronavirus in our world. This is my prayer for all of us through Christ our Lord.